Ronald Defeo Jr., who massacred his entire family in 1974 in their Amityville home while they slept. A case that gained national attention and spawned multiple books and movies. Ronald died Friday while in prison, according to his state prison record. Defeo, 69, was serving 25 years to life sentence at the Sullivan Correctional Facility in upstate Fallsburg for each of the 6 slayings records show. A State Department of Corrections and Community Supervision spokesman for Defeo was transferred to the Albany Medical Center and was pronounced dead at 6:35 p.m. Friday. The cause of death will be determined by the Albany County Medical Examiner's Office. Defeo's parents and 4 siblings were found dead in their beds, each with a single bullet in their back. Tales of angry spirits haunting the Dutch colonial-style Ocean Avenue home in the aftermath stunned Long Island and much of the country. Joseph Giaclone, a retired New York Police Department sergeant that was raised in Plain Edge, said if you grew up in Long Island, you knew about the home on Ocean Avenue. He said the killings lore was elevated with the 1977 novel, The Amityville Horror, and the 1979 cult horror film of the same name. The movie was based on claims by the Lutz family, who bought the house following the Defeo's murders, and said they had been forced to flee after being terrorized by paranormal activities. Other books and films based on the movies and murders would follow. As kids, we used to ride our bikes just to see the house like every other kid who grew up in the area. The movie made it famous. You'd go down there as kids, not really understanding the gravity of it, but you heard about all of the murders inside the house. Defeo, 23 at the time, shot each of his family members with a .35 caliber Martin lever-action rifle. The victims were Defeo's father, Ronald Defeo Sr., 43, his mother, Louise Defeo, 42, and siblings Dawn, 18, Allison, 13, Mark, 11, and John, 9, according to newspaper articles at that time. During his 1975 trial, Defeo admitted the killings. He was convicted of 6 accounts of second-degree murder. State Supreme Court Justice Thomas Stark called the murders the most heinous crimes. Defeo's lawyer had argued his client was insane when he killed his family. Defeo said he did it in self-defense after hearing voices that told him his family was plotting against him. A prosecution expert testified that while Defeo was an admitted LSD and heroin user, he was sane at the time of the murders. Former Newsday reporter and editor Bob Keeler, 77, of Stony Brook, interviewed Defeo at the Attica Correctional Facility in 1986. During the interview, Defeo changed his story and blamed his sister and mother for the deaths. He told Keeler, "People look in my eyes and think I'm possessed or something, and I'm sick of it." Defeo said in the interview that his sister Dawn shot their father, and his distraught mother shot Dawn and the other children. "I believe he wanted to tell another side of the story," Keeler said. Keeler recalled the widespread attention the case drew. It was a vicious crime, and it happened on a quiet Long Island suburb. People didn't think of Long Island as a place where mass murder happens. It was maybe a combination of the suburban settings and the supernatural of that area, which was a bit on the spooky side at the time.